In what may turn out to be one of the worst ecological disasters in recent memory, the EPA accidentally spilled millions of gallons of waste into the Animas River in Colorado, but why did it turn that freaky orange color? So the EPA made the Animas River orange on accident by spilling some wastewater out of a mine. I don't know about you, but I'm picturing like buffoonish guys carrying barrels of waste and one of them just trips and whoops, it just falls into the river. While there might have been some buffoonery, the whole incident is a little more complicated than that. Like most Western tales, it all starts with a mine. The Gold King mine near Silverton, Colorado, in fact. Most of the area is littered with mines, when in the late 1880s and 1920s, lots of people went looking for precious metals. But the thing about mining is, sooner or later, if you dig deep enough, you're gonna run into water. If the water ends up reacting with pyrite, or fool's gold, and oxygen, it will form a pool of sulfuric acid and dissolved iron. This acid isn't good on its own, but if it gets in contact with people, it can cause blindness, and if swallowed, it can burn holes in your insides. In this case, the water dissolved other minerals too, like lead and copper. Each metal is toxic on its own, but mix them all together and you get a really nasty soup of heavy metals. In the early days of mining, miners didn't have to do anything with wastewater because there was no one regulating it. Usually they just dumped it somewhere nearby, like a river. But in this case, a lot of it was still trapped inside the Gold King mine, or it was. The mine changed hands multiple times over the past few decades, and eventually it fell into disrepair. Now it had been leaking toxic water for a while now, which brings us to the EPA. The EPA knew the mine contained wastewater and was considered designating it a Superfund site since the 1980s, a designation reserved for only the worst toxic messes. Remediation efforts were underway, and that's what caused all this trouble. You see, the EPA was trying to clean up the site. The main goal was to install a pipe to drain some of the water and plug the mine so that all that toxic water would stay trapped inside the mine. While trying to excavate some of the fallen debris in the mine, some of that debris collapsed and it all went south really quickly. Toxic water started pouring into Cement Creek, a tributary of the Animas River, turning the Animas River the color of, well, Newsweek describes it as reminiscent of boxed mac and cheese. Yum. One EPA official said they were surprised that there was quite a bit more mine wastewater up there than they had expected. They were really trying to make things better, but they didn't. While initial reports estimated the spill at 1 million gallons, 4 days later it became apparent that 3 times that amount was actually spilled, releasing all those toxic heavy metals into the environment. The UK-based Guardian reported that the metals were like cadmium, arsenic, lead, copper, and manganese. At its peak, the mine was gushing about 500 gallons of water a minute. Most of these metals were released in an initial plume, where levels of lead spiked to 3,500 times the normal level, and arsenic 300 times normal. But according to a Colorado Parks and Wildlife test, the water isn't too deadly. They tested the toxicity of the water by placing cages of fish in the water for a few days. They've only had one fatality out of hundreds of fish, unlike a similar test during another big spill back in the 1970s, when a huge heavy metal loaded tailings pile spilled into the river. During that similar test with fish, nearly all died within 24 hours. So this isn't the first or worst disaster the river has ever seen, but we can hope it'll be the last. Already things seem to be clearing up. The EPA says the notoriously orange tint isn't visible anymore, but the river remains closed indefinitely. While this is just one recent example, there are tons of others of pollution endangering our national parks. To find out more about that, check out this video right here. So what do you think? Would you go swimming in an orange river? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.